In this video, I'm going to show you how to audit and manage your privacy settings in Windows 10. What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another video. As we know, Windows 10 collects a ton of different telemetry data. So going through the privacy settings, either after a major update or over time as you've uninstalled and installed programs, is a good idea to go through and audit and manage those to make sure that you're getting the best privacy that you can out of the operating system. So we're gonna go on over to the computer. I'm gonna show you how to do that and how to get into those settings to make sure that they fit exactly what you need. Real quick, as we know, with Windows, there are multiple ways to get to something that you're looking for. For today's demonstration, we're just gonna go through the start menu. So we're gonna left click on the start menu and we're gonna begin typing the word privacy, and you're gonna notice privacy settings is going to pop up. You can hit enter or left click on it, and that's going to open up the privacy window. Along the left hand side is what we're looking for. You can see app permissions and Windows permissions. We're gonna go down to camera and microphone. That's what we're gonna be using for today's demonstration. So we're going to click on camera. And you're gonna notice about halfway down the list, you have allow apps to access your camera, and then it's gonna list all of the different types of apps on the computer that have the ability to access the camera. Now, you may need to toggle these on and off. This is a good way to go through and audit which apps have access to it. If you've uninstalled and installed programs and it's been a while, you may need to come in here and just double check the settings. Also, if you've done a major update, you're gonna wanna come back in here and just make sure the settings haven't reset themselves as well. So again, Skype, Xbox Game Bar, you can toggle these on and off. Of course, if it's off, it doesn't have access to the camera. If it's on, you may still need to go into that specific app and still give it extra permissions. So it'll say, like right here, it says Microsoft Edge. Sites still need permission. So Edge as a whole has permission, but you still need to go in and give individual websites the permission to access the camera. So once again, you can just go through, toggle these on and off to meet your actual needs. And then of course, if you want to go in and disable the camera completely, you can do that by clicking the global on and off switch right up here. Now keep in mind, if you turn this off, and if you do like business webinars and stuff like that that require the camera, or you have a webcam when you're on the go, if you turn this off and you enable it in the browser, you still will not access the camera because you have given it a global off. So you'll need to come back here and turn that back on. Moving on to the microphone, very same setup. If you have right here, allow apps to access your microphone. Again, global setting, if you want nothing to access it, you won't have access to the mic. Your mic will not work. I've done this before because I came in here once and I was like, you know what? I don't want anything to have access to my microphone. I turned that off and I couldn't get my Discord to work because I came in here and I disabled it globally across all apps. So again, scroll down. It'll list all of the individual apps on the computer and you can toggle these on and off. Very similar to the camera, you're gonna want to come in here if you've updated to a new version of Windows or you've uninstalled and installed programs frequently, you're gonna want to come back in here, audit them, and make sure that all of the apps are matching the preferences that you're looking for. And that wraps up today's video, bringing us into our question of the day. What other privacy and security settings would you disable on Windows? Leave your answers in the comments section below the video. If you enjoyed the video and found it useful and informative, be sure to give it a thumbs up and check out some of the other videos that we have on this channel. We do a lot of stuff tech related, from how-tos and tutorials all the way over to tech news. I'll link a couple over there on the right-hand side of the screen. While you're at it, be sure to subscribe if you aren't already and enable the bell notifications so you guys don't miss out on any type of future content, and we will see you on the next one.